Grand Prix has been dominated over the years by Ferrari, McLaren and Williams. They have over 30 wins between them, so I expect a good showing from all of those teams here again today.
That's true, but Mercedes have such a strong package this year, it would surely be a mistake to rule them out of a chance of winning. However, Montreal is a very different type of circuit though, where you have to run the lowest downforce settings of the season so far. It's also extremely hard on brakes, so it's all to play for in today's session.
It's been a mighty qualifying performance from Mercedes today, with both cars on the front row for the race tomorrow.
Well, it's a great result for the team and one that we were expecting from them. Tomorrow, they'll be expecting both cars on the podium if it all goes to plan.
It's Sunday afternoon here in Montreal, and we're about to find out who's best prepared to take on this 4.3-kilometre track and, of course, the infamous Wall of Champions. We knew this was a track that suited the Mercedes well, but no one would have expected that Lewis Hamilton would have created such a gap to his rivals in qualifying. If he stays out of trouble and the car continues to perform, well, victory should surely be a formality.
There are a lot of variables that can cause a driver to be happy with the car one day to struggling with it the next. Track temperature, excessive tyre wear, or a change of fuel load can all affect the feel of a car. He'll definitely be hoping that when the race gets underway, he's got the same balance as he enjoyed in qualifying.
It was a good performance from Sebastian Vettel in the last race, his highest finish of the season. Is this a sign of an upturn in form for the German?
Well, I hope so. He's struggled to adapt since the change of the regulations and has been very open about the car not suiting his driving style. But like all the great drivers, though, he needs to learn how to adapt and maximise the potential from the car.
Going into the first corner, so try to keep it tidy. position for the time being. too bad at the moment. Just take care when you load them up. through sector one. Faster through sector one. We'll be right back. just ahead of Rosberg. Hamilton is ahead of you. A gap of 7 seconds separates you. We're gaining around 2/10 per lap. 4 laps remaining.
There's just something that feels right about seeing a Williams driver on the top step of the podium. A great result for the team today.
What a weekend it's been, and one that's been thoroughly enjoyable.
Well, what a weekend that has been. Please join us next time for another thrilling instalment of this Formula One season.